Good morning.
Morning.
This is the kind of morning you're going to want a piece of paper, or a piece of staff paper, or both. I mean, maybe you could do it without, but you're probably going to be happiest to have something to make notes in your head on. So, piece of paper, staff paper, both, whichever makes your day, and something to write with. All right, so what I thought we'd do this morning is take a look at about 8 measures of what is this thing called love. So I thought I'd do a little bit of show and tell, assuming I can make the little buttons work properly. So let's see. Share the sound. I don't do it often enough that I'm good at it, but I imagine I can keep improving. All right, so assuming I did it right, you should be able to hear in 2 seconds about 30 seconds worth of music. That's the amount that I'm thinking we're going to work on today. But I figured I'd show you a couple of different kind of treatments of it before we started to help get the tune in your head. So I'll play show and tell again in another second. Maybe there's a way that you can flip between while you're in there in the mode. Let's see. That gives a chance for Joy and Lorinda to add to us anyway. They're sort of with the program. All right. Different singer, same song.
What is this thing?
I got 3 of them ready for you guys. So, but that should like help really make it go into your head. All right. Same amount, different singer. Oh wait, I forgot to hit share. Not getting better with practice. All right, hopefully I did it right this time.
This funny thing.
So the lead sheet for this, sharing one more time. Yeah, see, I know I've got Carla dancing. It's working. The tune is going into your head. The lead sheet would look like this. And we're gonna do kind of the first two lines. And it's got a little repeat, so even though it doesn't look like as many measures, that's all it is. I want to see if I can make it that I can see you guys at the same time I'm talking to you. Where did you go? I'll deal. So we're going to be starting on a B flat. So that's B flat down to G. B flat. A flat. And if you're a cello person, third position works really nicely. Starting four on the D string. Then A flat. G and then D sharp, E. And that's the part we're interested in this morning. Right, so stop the share. There you are again. We'll play that much a couple of times. That's what we need. So starting on our B flat. One, two, three. In your brain, we're going to talk some about the harmony underneath it. So that first part, the first measure, we have a G minor, G, B flat, D, and F if you want to add the fourth note. So what I'd like to do is using only the G, D, and A strings because that's what everybody has in common. Play all the possible G, B flats, D flats, and F on those three strings. So if you want to make a note to yourself that that's what we're going to use, da-da-dum, to go with that, G, B flat, D flat, F. Those are your letters, assuming that helps. So snail speed that everybody can think about it, starting with G. The next possible one we would have would be the B flat. Position, B flat, D flat. So starting from the D flat, we're going to go downwards. We got D flat, B flat, F, B flat, D flat, back down, B flat, G, F, D flat, B flat, G. Now, legitimately, we should practice it on all four strings, but I'm trying to keep it a small amount to think about this morning. So, we're doing first position-ish and three strings worth. The next harmonic thing that happens, it would be like in the second measure, the measure that's got the tie of the G and the B-flat, the chord is gonna be C, E, G, and B-flat. C, E, G, and B flat. So, because we're starting on the G string as our lowest string, when we play those notes on our three strings, we're gonna still start on G. So we've got G, B flat. The next possible note would be C. Then on the D string we would have E. There's a B flat and a C. Starting from the C at the top, B flat, G, E, C, B flat, G. We'll do that again. G. For the next two measures. And the notes that we're going to use this morning are F, A flat, and C. So we use three. And since we're starting on the G string, the first possible note that we can use would be that A flat. So F, A flat, and C are our letters. And we're going to try that on three strings. So we've got A flat, C, F, A flat, C. Back down, C, A flat. To review all three of those in a row. So starting with G, we've got G, B flat, D flat, F, G, B flat, D flat, back down, D flat, B flat, D flat. No, I lost where I was. Starting at the top, D flat, B flat, G, F, D flat, B flat. playing part of the brain are not always connected. All right, second one, still starting on the G. We've got G, B flat, C, E, G, B flat, C, B flat, G, E, C, B flat, G. And the third one, starting with the A flat, A flat. So my thought was that I was going to talk about six possible chords, but I think we better stop at three for a second. What I'm going to do is basically start a band in a box, and I'm going to have it play the first four measures over and over and over and over again. I'm going to set it to loop. And so you may pick any one of those notes that we just practiced. So in the first measure, you can pick any one of the first notes that started with the G, G, B flat, D flat, F. And then in the second measure, use the C, E flat, G, B flat. In the third and fourth measures, use that F one, the F, A flat, C. You may find it helpful to put your bow down. Like, it can often be, I'm thinking so hard about what my next letter is that I want to use. So, I'm going to put mine down so that I'm not making too much noise anyway. And you can use any of those notes on any of your strings. So, I mean, if you want to plan ahead and be like, all right, I know there's B flat in the first two measures and there's A flat in the next measure, you could very happily, 100 times in a row, play B flat for 8 counts and A flat for 8 counts and be doing what we're doing. I mean, you could get more exotic about it and play different notes, but if you look at what's in common between the two of them, then yeah, you can do kind of the lazy version, or you could do like F for the first measure, E for the second measure, and then F again for the next two measures. So you truly get to pick any note on any string. You could decide, hey, I'm going to only play on the D string. What notes can I use? And like I said, I will set it to loop, and you can practice from those three chords any notes you want, and hopefully everything will be run very smoothly for us. It's got a two-measure count in, so this would be your G, C, F. G, C, F, F, G, C, F, F, G, C, F, G. Coming around again, here's your G. G. And you're glad you've spent the last year working on your scales and arpeggios. Because that went a lot better than it might have. So anyway, this is your chance for any sort of feedback and comments.
Happy Valentine's Day, everyone.
Happy Valentine's Day. Thank you, man.
Oh, good.
I'm like, Ella and Billy are my favorite.
Show and tell helped.
What happens next week?
I haven't decided yet, because we could do a little more of this type of thing. I did pick out a duet for cello and violin. I just wasn't sure when I wanted to start it, if we needed to do a little more sound exploring, since we've been feet first into the fairies for 5-6 weeks now. so. I also have a quartet that I did an arrangement of that I was thinking about using. But it's more awkward to try and play four parts than two. So, we'll see.
Thank you. Have a great day.
You're
welcome. Thank you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Have a great day.